Today on the channel, I smell a rat! A desert rat, that is, from the Valorverse Action Force line.
The spirit of the Warrior will run forever!
Welcome everyone, Kyle here, and welcome back to the channel for another Action Force unboxing and review. And today on the channel, we've got the Desert Rat. But for all your Action Force needs and a whole lot more, make sure you're hitting up Entertainment Earth. Use discount code Kyle, save 10% on all in-stock items, and of course, anything over $59 does ship free. And now, I had to get this elsewhere, as this is the Action Force packaging here, the more classic packaging, a variant packaging, I guess we'll call this. And it was actually $5 cheaper than the regular version. I said, well, I'm opening this anyways. Got to get a deal at the end of the day. I'll save $5, and that's exactly what I did. And another thing we're exactly going to do is do this review like we do all the other reviews on the channel. We're going to take a look at the packaging. We're going to talk about it. We're going to unbox it. We're going to talk about it. We're going to see where it goes from there. So without further ado, let's check out the packaging here. The only other one I have packaged like this, there was a limited edition Sergeant Slaughter. I think I showed it in a weekly purchases one time. But a neat packaging here. Of course, the Action Force was originally kind of the G.I. Joe name overseas. So we do see some of that in some of the older toy lines and stuff. So very cool. I like what they're doing here. I would definitely not be opposed if they did variants. Each one have both packaging. I think it might make some collectors go crazy. But I could see people taking lines. I'm going to take this packaging for me. Another guy wants this one. And I think it would be a cool idea. But it seems like they're putting some of these in here, and that's what they're doing here with Desert Rat today. But we got the familiar big window box there, window packaging, seeing all the stuff there, the Action Force logo, Desert Rat on the side, Desert Rat number 2, Series 2, figure number 7 right there, Action Force on the side, and on the back, there it is, got the big cross cell up top, you get the little QR code there, very smart, that's modern technology in packaging, I like what I see there. You got the huge file card. You guys know I'm a sucker for a file card. I'm not going to read this whole thing. I'll put up some highlights, but you can pause the video if you want to see what all the fuss is about with old Desert Rat. File name, Tony Roberts. Primary specialty, Special Forces. Medic, signaler, parachutist, regimental historian. Birthplace, let's see, Shoreham-by-Sea, England. Oh, the sea was angry, my friends. It was angry that day. I think the sea's angry right now, but that's where he is from. He is a staff sergeant in the Action Force. As a young adult, Roberts often found himself on the wrong side of the law. Never good, never good. A redemption story here. After witnessing the murder of a close friend, he knew he had to turn his life around before he ended up in prison or dead. And never good to have a close friend die, and reminds him, well, I guess it wasn't a close friend, and I guess she didn't die, but the girl I sat next to in sixth grade, oh, sixth grade, what a time to be alive that was, she actually went home from school one day and killed her grandma. Yeah, she killed her grandma, stabbed her like 50 times or something. It was all over the news, everything else, and Christina, who sat next to me, who had a crush on me apparently, oh man, watch out, what I could have been in for, but she killed her grandma. How many of you guys went to class with a murderer? You just shared a desk with a murderer. So very strange. Years later, she was back in the news. She was dying of cancer in prison, and she was trying to get released or something for the last couple of months of her life, and they didn't allow it. So very strange. So I don't know where that story came from, but the more you know, folks, the more you know. But very cool. A lot of stuff going on here. You got action points. 2 action points. Man, I'm here for the action points. Supposedly, has anybody found out? What are they doing with those action points? I thought it was supposed to be announced. Maybe I just missed it. I'll have to look into that a little bit. But there it is. Nothing too fun back there. Off to the side. See you later. Oh, love this. And I love it even more because it comes in a baggie. Now, not all of them come in a baggie, as we do know. But this one does. And I love it because you can put all this gear and everything. There's a baggie for you right here. And then you get your stand, your Action Force stand. You guys know I love to take my last stand. I'm all about stands on my figures. Absolutely love that. And there's the old Desert Rat there, looking like he just came out of the desert. There you go. Makes sense. There it is. We're going to pull him out. See what all the fuss is about right there. Plastic. See you later. And then you got the, oh yeah, I forgot. You got the little, not cellophane. I guess cellophane. You got that protector on there. I don't hate that either. Protect the figures. See you later. Goodbye. And let's pop everything out. See what's up with the old Desert Rat here. He's got a big backpack, all kinds of hands, all kinds of stuff going on. Always cool. Of course, this line, as we've seen, we've done tons and tons of unboxings here on the channel. Make sure you check all those out. See you later. A lot of reuse. Reuse is the name of the game here, but I'm okay with it. It makes sense when used right, and it's been going on as old as time. As old as action figures have been around, we've been seeing reuse. And speaking of reuse, we get the usual hand assortment here from the Action Force brand. We got two Fists of Fury. When your weapons fail, you got to rely on your fists, and hopefully those won't fail. You got the cupping hand right here. Of course, you're going to put the gun right there, so you do have two of those hands, a left and a right. And then you got two traditional gripping hands with the side-to-side hinge, and I believe the ones on here are the vertical up and down. There it is. So you get both trigger hands there, up and down or side to side. Choose your own hand adventure, as we always do say. He does got the big old backpack here. He's loaded for bear. He's got all kinds of stuff in there. He's got his lifeblood in here. If he's out in the desert, he's out doing stuff. He's got all kinds of compartments here. Very G.I. Joe-like. You got the peg hole, fits in the back of the character all day long. I understand what I'm seeing here. So very, very nice. All one color. I can see people saying, give me a dash of other colors here, but for me, it works just fine. So we get the backpack there. Then we get two weapons with him looking really, really nice. Like the little handgun here. Always should have a big gun and a handgun with these guys as long as they do use those. This makes sense to me. Of course, does have the holster in there, so that makes it even better. Looking really nice there. And then the big old, this is a machine gun, assault rifle. You guys know me. I don't know my guns, but this one does look really, really nice. Love the different colors on this. Really makes this pop. Makes it look more, less a toy, more of a miniature scaled version is what this looks like. So I really, really do like this. He will definitely be holding this on my display. All in on that one. He does come with a few other things, it looks like. We do have that knife right there in the pouch on his front. So we got a nice knife there. Gray handle, black blades. We've seen that before. And then he does have a few different magazines in there. Magazines, clips, magazines. People get worked up about that. You get a magazine pouches right there. He's got two silver ones in there, looking good. And then you do get a scarf, which I believe we've seen before as well. But you do have that floating around, looking really, really nice. What is this on the side? I think that's new, and that must be more clips, magazines, clips. Magazine right there stuck on the side. That looks really cool. I like the attention to detail on this belt. Obviously, you can store your weapons there, but it's got some cool things there with the different colors looking really, really nice. Got that side piece right here on his thigh as well, looking really nice there. And then the backpack, of course, you can plug right in the hole in the back. It's got the big old vest going on, looking really, really nice. Just an all-around good-looking figure, especially the tan color that he has going on against kind of the greenish color. It really does make it pop, makes it stand out. And usually we're used to the darker colors with some of these characters. This lighter one works really, really good. Good head sculpt on in there. Got a haircut. Looks like he just got trimmed up. He's got a buzz going on. Got a little bit of 5 o'clock shadow going there as well. He has two ears. He is human. How about that? He's got ears looking good. I forgot to mention the old antenna on the back. That also looks nice. Got a communicator, a little walking talkie, a carabiner, and the old Union Jack right there as well, representing the country. Representing the motherland. Love the tattoos there on the forearm, as we haven't got a ton of tattoos, I don't think, for the Valorverse line. I'm trying to think back, but I do like that attention to detail. Sleeve rolled up, a little bit of tattoo poking out. I think that does look really, really good as well. Of course, head's going to be removable, but you got the side to side, up and down. Very tight articulation joints on these figures, as we know. Arms all the way around. You got the butterfly shoulders, always good on these. Bicep cut, double jointed, pinless elbows. The hits being played right here at the table. Hands going to be removable. Hands are not as easily removable as I would like them to be. We always talk about that with these. You heat them with a hairdryer or some hot water real quick, they will pop out and in really easily, but it's just an extra step. And now that I have a hairdryer down in my basement, I have no excuses anymore. But you do have that. You got the big waist, the big hula hoop at the waist, tons of articulation right there. He can do those big old desert rat splits. If he's got to jump over a cactus out there in the desert, he can do that. Then you do get the drop down hips that feel really nice. Side to side, back and forth on the old thigh. Double jointed pinless knees. You know I'm here for that as well. And then you get the boot cut side to side, back and forth. Got a little different color tan shoes compared to the pants on this one as well. But looking really, really nice at the end of the day. No issues with this old desert rat. I like to build out the team. I like kind of different team members being a different cast of characters. Instead of everybody looking the same, they all bring their own little personalities, their own looks into the figures, and that's what we get here with this desert rat figure. I like what I see, and I'm all in. You guys know me, I'm all in on these Valorverse figures. Obviously, you know, I love my G.I. Joe, and I know there's some Action Force fans out there and some Joe fans that want to fight back and forth between the two lines and stuff, but man, for me, we're living in a glory time. I'm all in on both of them. Why not both, is what I say. Obviously, for me, though, I have more of a history and affinity for the G.I. Joe brand. Heck, I've been playing with them as long as I can remember. So obviously, I'm going to love the Shipwrecks and the Flints of the world, all the iconic characters I've grown with for my whole life. But it's cool to get some of these guys as well. You can mix them in with your Joes as background guys, new team members, or have them on their own shelf. Whatever you want to do, choose your own action figure adventure. But I really like what I'm seeing here, and I continue to support this brand. I'm very excited for the future of the brand as well. And it sounds like they got a lot of stuff in the pipeline coming down very, very soon for us. So Deseret, hey, he gets a thumbs up in my book. But what about your book? Is it left unwritten so far? You guys let me know in the comments your thoughts on the old Deseret figure. Of course, don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Turn on the old notification bell. And don't forget about the Patreon, your best way to support the channel. You get early access to videos like this, bonus content, exclusive content, giveaways, Q&As, you name it. A lot going on Patreon. Like I said, your best way to support the channel. You can also support the channel over at ProWrestlingTees.com. Search Kyle Peterson. And don't forget to hit me up and follow along on social media, SirPaul64 on Twitter, Instagram, the_Kyle_Peterson. So for a Deseret Rat, I'm a Kyle Rat. And I'll see you guys all real soon.